to everyone. Today is a historic day for the scientific community of Sri Lanka. We are meeting here at the largest international gathering of scientists, technologists, and professionals ever held in Sri Lanka. On behalf of the government, let me very warmly welcome all of you to this inaugural session of the Science and Technology for Society Sri Lanka Forum 2016. Attending the event tonight, we have eminent scientists and professionals from 23 countries. You have come from the United States of America, Russian Federation, United Kingdom, Japan, Germany, France, India, Canada, China, South Korea, Malaysia, Australia, Pakistan, and many friendly countries. Among you, there are over 30 expatriate Sri Lankan scientists as well. To come here, you have traveled far and wide amidst your other responsibilities. You are participating in this event in order to foster excellence in science and technology globally, while making Sri Lanka an important partner. In this audience, there are over 600 Sri Lankan scientists representing science and technology institutes, universities, and research institutes. I warmly welcome all of you. Ladies and gentlemen, under the visionary leadership of His Excellency Maithripala Sirisena, the President of Sri Lanka, policies and programs are being formulated to implement our country's obligations under international agreements. This forum is one of the important steps that signifies the commitment of the government of Sri Lanka. On behalf of this audience, I take this opportunity to recognize the strategic foresight of our Prime Minister in linking science, technology, and research as a driving force of socio-economic development of Sri Lanka. The idea of this forum was first conceived by Honorable Ranil Wickremesinghe, our Prime Minister, who delivered a keynote speech at the Science and Technology in Society Forum held in Kyoto, Japan, October 2015. The Prime Minister asked me to work with the international scientific community and take steps to orient our science and technology institutions towards UN Sustainable Development Goals. The logo of this forum that you see reflects the link between sustainable development goals and science and technology for society. Among the 17 UN Sustainable Development Goals, there are targets set in areas of basic human needs, as well as in areas of protection of human life in a healthy environment. Sri Lanka became a signatory to the Paris Agreement on Climate Change in April 2016. In recognition of the importance and relevance to sustainable development in Sri Lanka, the ministerial subject of environment protection and promotion is exercised directly by His Excellency the President. My ministry now has a huge challenge of making science and technology a key factor of national development. To meet this challenge, my ministry and its 12 institutions have to work with many other ministries of government, private sector, and provincial institutions. Therefore, we have invited representatives of those institutions and other ministries and corporate business to attend the inauguration as well as the forum. Let me warmly welcome all of you who have accepted our invitation. Ladies and gentlemen, the forum, which will be held at Water's Edge for 3 days from tomorrow to the 10th, will address themes such as the role of science and technology in achieving sustainable development goals, citizen science, advanced technology-based solutions, capacity building in science, technology and innovation, science and technology funding, and the establishment of a Sri Lankan innovation platform. Tomorrow morning, the forum will be ceremonially opened by Honorable Ranil Wickremesinghe, the Prime Minister, while the opening address will be delivered by the Science and Technology Advisor to Honorable Prime Minister of Malaysia, Mr. Sakari. The keynote address will be delivered by Honorable Koh Jee Omi, former Minister of Finance and former Minister of Science and Technology, Government of Japan, who is the founder of Science and Technology in Society Forum, Japan. The last day of the forum, September 10th, will be devoted to further discussions on the way forward and the wrap-up ending with a Colombo resolution which will incorporate the conclusions of science, technology and innovation for global partnerships and national development in Sri Lanka. Our forum will analyze, discuss and debate on a wide range of issues on the growing influence of science on people's lives. In Sri Lanka, we are now taking steps to build institutional capacity in research and development. In the process, we will empower the scientists to make decisions and provide leadership to formulate integrative programs for fostering cooperation among the research and development institutions. We will enhance research funding, support human resource development within institutions, and foster international collaboration. We have already agreed with CERN Laboratory in Geneva to train our young scientists in advanced courses in solid-state physics. Let me say a few words about implementation of science and technology policy for society. As you are aware, Sri Lanka is now embarking on constitutional reforms. One of the objectives of reforms is to build the capacity of public administration, including our research and development institutions. We will recruit more and more from scientific and professional groups to policy and decision-making positions of government institutions, including ministries. We will have new institutional mechanisms to assess performance of research and development institutions so that we will drive scientists and professionals to achieve their organizational objectives. While financial audit focuses on compliance, performance assessment will focus on delivery of results. Ladies and gentlemen, with the implementation of comprehensive administrative reforms, our institutions will have greater autonomy and our human talent will be free to drive the organizations in the right directions. For example, we have the problem of our inventions unable to reach the world of commercial production. Technology transfer, whether from advanced countries to developing countries, or from the home or the laboratory, or the inventor to the hands of the consumer, faces numerous obstacles. For example, our young inventors every year come up with hundreds of patentable inventions. Some of them proceed to the level of international awards, but hardly any of them reach the commercial stage. Under the process of innovation, is institutionalized by linking our research and development institutions with investors and business firms. We cannot expect science and technology to serve our society as expected. Along with an improved domestic system of technology transfer from laboratory to industry and agriculture, we would be better prepared to link ourselves with global centers of research and development. The process of local economic development, including foreign investment, must be linked to international flow of new knowledge, know-how, and products and services that are based on information technology. We must be prepared well at the receiving end of technology transfer, for which it will be essential to have a well-equipped science park and a technology park. I am pleased to tell you that we have already taken initial steps to establish such infrastructure with technical support of UNESCO. The society will support the efforts and investments in science and technology in this country when people see the day that their problems of nutrition, lack of water, cost of energy, causes of ill health, lack of shelter, and effects of natural and environmental disasters are addressed sufficiently. Naturally, they will support allocation of more resources for such priority areas as biotechnology, nanotechnology, information and communication technology, advanced materials and mechatronics. Ladies and gentlemen, scientists and their institutions must formulate the objectives by understanding the real issues of society for which they must take multidisciplinary and holistic approaches. Two-way communication with producers and consumers is essential for science and technology to begin to serve the people. Great economic investment opportunities lie ahead of us with the advancement in the fourth industrial revolution, which is the digital revolution. These opportunities are seen in many fields, and health is just one of them. Digital health is the convergence of the digital and genomic revolutions with health, healthcare, living and society. My ministry is giving serious attention to the ways of entering the digital health industry. We plan to be active at international level for genomic medicine, precision medicine, personalized medicine, e-health, and their commercialization. In terms of economic competitive advantage in global health industry, I see this is as a gold mine for Sri Lanka. Establishing a rational link between science, technology, and society is rooted in economic and commercial thinking. This is why we, the constitutional reformers, are now proposing to establish a national planning commission in Sri Lanka. Such an apex body, we believe, would be able to provide the much needed coordination and holistic thinking at the higher levels of policy and planning. Your Excellency, by way of conclusion, I want to say that I took the opportunity given to me today to share with this very important audience some of the steps that the Ministry of Science, Technology and Research is taking, as well as the thinking behind those steps. I believe that these ideas would serve the purpose of introducing to you the STS Forum 2016. Finally, I wish to announce that all arrangements are in order for us to proceed with the forum deliberations for next 3 days. With your commitment to duty and cooperation with our organizers, I am sure that our historic event will be a memorable one. Thank you.
If you are wearing spectacles, you are using an ancient Sri Lankan technology. To date, there are 11 asteroids named after Sri Lankan names. Asteroids have been named to honor contributions in the field of technological innovation and scientific advancement. Many serendipitous discoveries have changed the history of science, and this is the history of science and technology of the Isle of Serendip. The evolution of Sri Lankan science and technology. Homo sapiens balangodensis. Testing of geometric microliths found at the site confirmed that they were remnants of stone tools. Balangodaman was the most advanced man in the world at that time.
It is with great pleasure and expectation that I participate at this forum of the Science and Technology for Society. I thank the organizers for selecting Sri Lanka to conduct this meeting. I understand that there are over 100 scientists participating from several countries for Sri Lanka. This is a historic event. As a politician, I will look at how science could be utilized to political needs, how science and technology could answer the issues raised by society. In short, it is about the politics of science. Therefore, I take this opportunity to share with you my political thinking of society with focus on science and technology. In other words, what the society expects from science and technology. In Sri Lanka, our society is rooted in agriculture and in a rural setting. Most of you also have roots in this rural society. You are familiar with farmers' problems. How many of our scientists go to our villages to understand and find answers to these complex problems? How many farmers or laborers or grassroots level technicians have access to research in scientists? How many of research publications are understood by our rural societies? I believe that to promote multidisciplinary approaches to scientific research, we must encourage cooperation between natural and social sciences. Several people suffer from drinking poor quality water, resulting in chronic kidney diseases. It is scientific research and development that had created several chemical-based fertilizers and weedicide and pesticide used by farmers to obtain larger harvest but cause chronic kidney diseases. If the scientists are efficient, they should find alternative for this kind of fertilizers. Research and development output will have no social value unless they are transferred to the level of production. I take this opportunity to request the scientific community to step up their effort to provide Sri Lanka better access to scientific expertise, information and technology, especially in the areas of agriculture, industry, health and water management. I wish to thank Honorable Susil Premajayanta, Minister of Science, Technology and Research, and the organizers for the wonderful arrangement made for this historic meeting. I invite you to visit my native district, Polonnaruwa, and observe the remarkable scientific and technological system we have inherited in irrigation, religious and cultural infrastructure development from ancient Sri Lanka. I would like to convey my greetings to all participants and to the foreign delegates. I wish your stay a pleasant and enjoyable one. Maithamat Satru Venua, Vidyakinge Takshanika Me Samalu, Visheshen Maperate, Mani Avastak Pavatala, Jatigavashen Vagema, Antharjatigavashen, Danuma, Takshanika Jnane, Me Siala Mulumahat, Loka Mano Prajavage Saha, Sielu Satuyagi, Sielu Sabavika Sampati, Surakshita Savya, ආරක්ෂාව පෝෂණය සහ සංවර්ධනය වෙනුවෙන් ඔබේ දැනුම අධ්‍යක්ීම් පරමතභාවය විද්වත්භාවය තුල ප්‍රබුද්ධ මානව සමාජයක් සඳහා ඔබ සියල්ලේගෙම තිබෙන කැපවීම පිළිබඳව විශේෂයෙන්ම විද්‍යාඥයින්ගේ තාක්ෂණ වේදීන්ගේ දැනුම අවබෝධය සහ අධ්‍යක්ීම් සෑම විටම දුගීභාවය දුප්පත්කම අවම කිරීම සඳහා රටක සංවර්ධනය තුල ගොඩනැගෙන මිනිස් සමාජයේ වඩාත් දැනුම උපයෝගී කරගනිමින් උසස් සමාජයක තිබෙන්නා වූ ප්‍රමිතිය ගුණාත්මකභාවය වර්ධනය කිරීම සඳහා ඔබේ පර්යේෂණ සහ අධ්‍යක්ීම් තුල සියලු ශේෂ්ත්‍රයන්හි විශිෂ්ටත්වයේ පෙන්눔 කරන බව මා විශ්වාස කරනවා ඒ නිසා මේ සමලුව අපේ රටේ ඓතිහාසික අවස්ථාවක් වගේම ඒ විශේෂ අවස්ථාවක් ඒ නිසා අපේ උතුම් ශ්‍රී ලංකා මාතෘභූමිය තුලින් මේ විද්‍යාර්ථීන්ගේ පර්යේෂකින්ගේ දැනුම තුල සියල්ල මුළුමහත් මානව සහ සත්ත්ව සමාජයේ සියලු පරිසර ශේෂ්ත්‍රයන්හි අනාගත අභිවෘද්ධිය සඳහා යොදන ලෙස ඉතාමත් ගෞරවයෙන් ඉල්ලා සිටිමින් ඔබ සියලු දෙනාට ස්තුතිවන්ත වෙමින් මගේ කතාව අවසන් කරනවා thank you
well there are three principles that govern the relationship of scientific advisors to their ministers and the first one is the clarity of roles and responsibilities the second is independence and the third is transparency and openness and I'll say something on each of these it is very clear that in a democracy we elect our representatives to make decisions scientific advisors do not make decisions they give the advice of the pros and cons of doing something or doing nothing about any given measure I certainly remember on one occasion being asked by a minister directly well what would you do under these circumstances and I said well minister if solving this problem was the only matter I would do this and she said to me but I would never get re-elected doing that so what's your next best idea and so it is important to remember that in a democracy scientists are there to advise not to make decisions
it's my great honor and privilege to have been invited to propose a vote of thanks on the opening ceremony of science and technology for society forum sri lanka 2016 which is a pioneering scientific event in the history of sri lanka we believe this forum would provide an opportunity to develop interaction among scientists research institutions and industries as well as promote advanced technologies to industrial sector I on behalf of the ministry of science technology and research and the entire steering committee of science and technology for society forum extend a vote of thanks to all honorable speakers for sharing thoughts with us today for the first instance let me express a very hearty thanks to your excellency maitripala sirisena president of democratic socialist republic of sri lanka for gracing this occasion and sharing encouraging thoughts with us We are grateful to Honorable Ranil Wickremesinghe, Prime Minister of the Democratic Socialist Republic of Sri Lanka, for the support extended to us to initiate this event. I may express our sincere thanks to Honorable Susil Premajayanta, Minister of Science, Technology and Research, for giving excellent guidance for organizing a successful Science and Technology for Society forum in Sri Lanka. And Honorable Lakshman Senivaratna, State Minister of Science, Technology and Research, thank you as well for the support. I am also grateful to Professor Michael J. Kelly, who is the Prince Philip Professor of Technology at University of Cambridge, for accepting our invitation and delivering the keynote speech in this opening session. Your analysis emphasizing the importance of active participation of the people representatives and the policy makers in making policies and deliverables on the ground for science-related program with a close collaboration of the scientific community and the civil society. I am grateful to all the honorable ministers, honorable members of parliament, ambassadors, secretaries, district secretaries and vice chancellors of the universities and the eminent scientists and professionals for joining us today. I also extend our thanks to officials of the presidential secretariat, prime minister's office, Ministry of Foreign Affairs and other ministries, research institutions and the students for their enormous cooperation in organizing of this event. Further, I thank my ministry officials as well. Finally, I would like to take this opportunity to place our gratitude to the multinational agencies such as GIZ, WIPO, JICA, JSLIP, UK, IERI and the private companies for financial support and technical guidance they have extended to us. Honorable guests, ladies and gentlemen, once again I want to state that we are all most grateful to all speakers, invitees, and sponsors. We thank you for being with us this evening. It has been a great pleasure. And now I wish to invite all of you to join with us enjoying our traditional cultural program. Thank you for your.
Tene naga tene 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 tene.